Nuskier Productions. All right, folks, this is going to be the time-lapse drive from Whistler to Vancouver. Maybe a little interesting than driving up from Vancouver to Whistler. We started off in Whistler Village, worked our way over to Creekside, and you see we just launched Creekside. My apologies, you can see that I'm kind of restricted where I can put my camera here, so it's going to be an upright phone shot this instead of more of a wide angle, which would have done much better when it came to seeing the scenery. Anyways, with this, folks, this one's a little bit longer than normal, but 3 minutes and change. I'll figure out what music to put in here after I've done the voiceover. But as you can see, this is the drive down from Whistler to Vancouver, ending at Lionsgate Bridge. So with this one, along the way, we did run into a few different police points here. So again, with this, folks, speed limit's posted. It's electronically adjusted in places. Don't be that guy that is in a hurry to basically get pulled over or an accident. Respect the signs, respect the weather, and respect the other guys in the road here. Anyways, coming up here to Squamish pretty soon, and then from that, we'll let you just ride on into Vancouver. There we go, Squamish, and away we go. So, like I say, from here, it's about a half hour, 45 minute drive from Whistler down to Squamish. And then from Squamish to the bridge is about an hour. If you're coming from the airport, it's going to take you a few minutes, hopefully, to get through town. Depends on the time of day that you're going through, get stuck in traffic. As they have really no significant highways for moving people around through the town. Downtown, it could be kind of quite the gridlock if you hit it at the magic hour of coming home from work time. A lot of people trying to get back across the bridge. You'll note when we get up there, the bridge is actually at 3 lanes, but it will be directional with two going one way, one going the other. Usually two going in the morning and two coming out at night. The other lane reserved for the opposite direction. Anyways, you can see we've got open water here to our right, so we're getting pretty close to North Vancouver here, and as we get to the bridge, we'll just slow down a little bit. Again, this is a time lapse of my camera, so it's not optimal. Normally, I like to speed things up, but cameras get limited memory. And like I said, total drive time usually about 2 hours from the bridge to Whistler, or vice versa. And give yourself about an hour to get through town. So, like I said, come down for Whistler. Give yourself 3 hours to get to the airport, especially an hour through town, plus the requisite, you know, hour and a half to 2 hours before the flight. But again, folks, here's the bridge. A little bit of a drive through town, up onto the ramp, and across the bridge we go. And as you can see, I've kind of slowed the camera down here artificially. Anyways, folks, that's the drive from Whistler to Vancouver. Thanks a lot. Have a great day. Bye for now.